first thing that we're going to talk about today is loving Christ. And here at Relevant Church, what we want is every single person to experience the love of Christ through a personal relationship with Jesus. And I've got Susie and Hannah with me today. And I just wanted us to kind of think about and remember, like, when we trusted Christ. For me, I was 13 years old, and I remember sitting on the back row of a balcony section in the school that I went to. And Dr. Clayton Bailey actually led me through the sinner's prayer, where I realized that I admitted that I was a sinner and I needed a savior. And literally, I've never forgotten it.
Yeah. I was like 5 years old. So I believe that, you know, God says that come as you are, come as a child. And you can understand at five that you do wrong and that Jesus went to the cross to pay for your sins and that you can accept Jesus in your heart. And I remember sitting on this red plaid couch with my mom and just praying, you know, the prayer, Jesus, forgive me, come into my heart and save me. And it was as simple as that. And I know that Jesus did that for me that day.
Yeah. I think I grew up like in the church, you know, and I just spent every single Sunday and every single Wednesday at church. And I think it took me some hard things in my life to walk through to really like actually dive deeper from that lukewarm faith to an actual like on fire relationship with the Lord. So I think, you know, it just takes some things in your young adult years to really learn and to walk through in order to experience that true authentic relationship with Christ.
And so what we're talking about in this first section is our beliefs.
Yeah.
And we're talking about baptism. And then how do we equip ourselves to kind of walk through this thing? And we believe that belief in baptism, it really matters. And belief is just like what you said, Susie. It's as easy as ABC. It's admitting that we've done wrong. Yeah. And the Bible clearly talks about that in Romans chapter 3 and verse 23, where it says, everybody's sin. Like, and the word everybody is sin, sin means just miss the mark and fallen short of God's glory or his standard for living. And so we have to admit that. Then we have to believe that Jesus did what he said he did on the cross, which means that he went to the cross as God's son, as a perfect sacrifice for our sin. And then we actually confess that he's Lord, that he did all those things. And we say, I want to receive what you have for us. That for us is belief. And right on the heels of that is baptism, because we believe that baptism is our first step of obedience in following Jesus. And so right now you guys are going to watch a story of Elena, who shares her story of faith and then shares her story of baptism.
So I grew up Catholic, and growing up, you went to Catholic Mass. It was very structured. You went to the Sunday school. On Tuesdays, you did children's choir, but nothing came back home. You didn't really develop a personal relationship with Jesus. I didn't realize that until I started coming to Relevant. I felt a massive change. Even the first time I came to Relevant, I cried probably three times the first time I was here with my friends. I never realized that there was a relationship like this in my future. I never realized that I was going to be called to have such a relationship with him. And it's been incredibly special to me. I can feel him moving in my life. Ever since coming here, I've been feeling a pit in my stomach when I knew that there was something wrong and I needed to make a different decision than what I was previously going to make, not even 6 months ago. I've had friends and mentors that have led me through this and that have helped me to work my way into a better life, and I cannot be more grateful. So on the day of my baptism, I was very apprehensive about it. I didn't even know that day that I was going to be baptized. Kind of had it in the back of my mind that, oh, maybe I'll do this. I wore my swimsuit just in case. It was at the beach baptism. After hearing the message that day, I decided, yeah, I would like to talk to someone about this, because my apprehensions were my whole family's Catholic. They would not see it the way that I would. But after explaining this to some of my family members, they became very, very happy for me. And I knew that I had made one of the best decisions that I could have made for my life. Jesus is my friend, I can see how much that he loves me. And I know that he wants the absolute best for me.
I hope you guys were able to identify with Elena's story. And Hannah, when you were sharing your story, it's interesting because you grew up in church, which a lot of people grow up in church. And I think some people think that it was just because they grew up in church that made them a Christian.
Or I was always a Christian is what I hear a lot of times in Belong Glass.
Yeah. And I know that that wasn't your experience. So share with us like that thing where it was like you had a childlike faith where you prayed a prayer, but then you had something where you said, this is when I started making my faith my faith.
Yeah, so I don't necessarily remember like the specific date or time or anything like that of when I was a child and accepted the Savior, but I walked through some stuff in my young adult years that really just set me on fire for the Lord. Like I got to that breaking point of I absolutely need Christ at such a deeper level than I was walking with previously. I moved from that lukewarm faith to on fire for
That's
the Lord.
Awesome.
I think that goes right into the second part of our belief in baptism and equipping yourself. Because really, that's what you started doing. You started saying, I'm not just going to come on Sunday morning and be equipped. I'm going to equip myself every single day in my faith journey, which is what God has called us to do.
And that's what loving Christ is.
Yeah.
It's developing that personal, intimate relationship with Christ and moving forward, right?
Because God gives us tools to equip ourselves in our faith journey. And I love what Ephesians 4 says. It says, now these are the gifts Christ gave to the church, the apostles, the prophets, the evangelists, and the pastors and teachers. Their responsibility is to equip God's people to do the work that God's called them to do. And I believe that there's a lot of ways that we can do that and equip ourselves.
There's a lot of methods out there that you can equip yourself.
Yeah, and I don't think one is right. Hannah, you journal a little bit, don't you? Like, Hannah, I knew that Hannah loves to journal. Like, I don't journal, but I love to listen to other pastors, and I love to listen to podcasts, and I love to listen to books and everything. And Hannah actually throws me on to some books that recently she's like, oh, Paul, you should listen to this book.
But really, it's the time in the Word alone with you and God, whatever it looks like, whether you're journaling, whether you're listening, whether you're jotting down notes or however you learn.
And there's a couple of those things inside of the book. So inside of the book that you guys are going to get today, there are some ways to do it. One is called the SOAP method, which is literally scripture, observation, application, and prayer. That's SOAP. And everybody can do that. It's super simple. But we also have some other times of prayer. What does prayer look like? And if you have questions about that, you can ask the person who's leading this study today, and they'll help you understand prayer. And then we have a couple of tools that we have here at Relevant Church. One, we use YouVersion. YouVersion is the Bible online. And if you just go to Bible.com, that's where you find it. And literally, you can actually download the Bible on your phone and read it every single day. Or it'll read itself to you if you just ask it to.
Or you can join like with friends and have a Bible plan. So it's just really taking that time getting in the Word to do that.
We also have another thing called Right Now Media. And inside of your book, there's a QR code that you can scan the QR code. Right Now Media is kind of like Netflix for Christians.
It really is.
And it's got tons of Bible studies. Yeah. I know, Hannah, you've used it with
multiple
your small
times.
Group time.
Yeah, yep. Yeah, 100%.
So it's a great thing, though, even in your personal time where you're growing and learning, that you can just really delve into some studies on your own and have some people there teaching.
So here's what I want to encourage you to do now. I want you to share your faith story with the people around the table in your small group today.